Hare Krishna. The worship of the demigods reaches Krishna, but the worshipper doesn't. There is a popular saying in Hindu circles, Akashat Patitam Toyam Yatha Gacchati Sagaram Sarvadevam Namaskaram Keshavam Prati Gacchati. Says that just as water that falls from the sky reaches the ocean, similarly, whichever God one worships, Sarvadeva Namaskaram Keshavam Prati Gacchati, it goes to Keshava. And this saying is often used to support the idea that worship of all gods is the same. We can worship whichever god we want because ultimately all worship will reach Krishna. And the idea underlying it is that ultimately all gods are one. But does this verse actually support this notion? Because, not exactly, because the verse clearly points to Keshava's distinct position as contrasted with other gods, because Keshava Krishna is mentioned as the ultimate object of worship. To him, all worship needs to go, just as the ocean is the ultimate destination of water. So, now to clarify this point further, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur expands this analogy by inserting the worshipper as the source of water. Means, in the original analogy, the water falls from the sky and then it goes to the ocean. But Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur modifies the analogy, says that suppose a worshipper offers water in a river and then the river water flows through the river to the ocean. So now the water will go to the ocean, but the worshipper will not go to the ocean. Similarly, he explains that the worship that is offered to the demigods, that will go to Krishna, but the worshippers themselves won't go to Krishna. Why is that? Because the demigod worshippers' hearts are not devoted to Krishna. They are devoted to the demigods. And Gita explains in the 8th chapter, 6th verse, that we attain ultimately after our death whatever we are most attached to. Yam yam va pisparan bhavam tijatyante kalevaram tam tam evaiti kaunteya sadatad bhava bhavita. This was his general principle, that whatever we are most attached to, that we will attain after death. And this general principle is explained specifically with respect to the object of worship in the Gita in 9.25, where Krishna says, where the Gita says that Yanti deva vrita devan pitran yanti pitravataha bhutani yanti bhuteja yanti mad yajinopi maam. So yanti deva vrita devan, so those who worship the devatas go to the devatas, and like that those who worship different objects go to different objects. And Krishna says that those who worship me come to me. So why this difference between the destinations of demigod worshippers and Krishna worshippers? The previous verse 9.24 states the reason, that the demigod worshippers don't know Krishna's supreme position. Ahami sarva yajnanam bhokta cha prabhureva cha natumam abhijananti tatve natascha vantite. Says that I am the ultimate object of worship, sarva yajnanam bhokta. But those who do not understand it, tatve natas chavantite. Chavantite, fall down. And after that, now we can understand this with another example to understand Krishna's supreme position. If the universe is managed by a cabinet of ministers in which Krishna is the head. So Krishna is the ultimate king. Now, there are some souls who are not yet spiritually evolved enough to worship Krishna. So Krishna doesn't reject them, he accommodates them by providing other objects of worship intermediately, that is the devatas. He says, that means to elevate the souls, Krishna says, if you can't worship me, then you worship the demigods and make some limited spiritual advancement by that. So it is Krishna who gives the demigods the power to fulfill the benedictions to fulfill the, to provide the benedictions to their worshippers. And now, when the citizens offer some taxes to the ministers, the taxes go to the king. Similarly, when the demigod worshippers worship the demigods, that worship ultimately goes to Krishna. But the citizens may not know about the king only, because they are interacting only with the minister. Similarly, the demigod worshippers don't know about Krishna, and they know only the demigods. That's why their devotion remains restricted to the demigods, and that's why they attain the demigods. They don't attain Krishna. However, if the demigod worshippers are ready to let Gita wisdom enlighten them, then they too can attain, they expand their devotion to Krishna, and thereby attain life's eternal supreme destination. Thank you. Hare Krishna.